parallel hip distance. We'll start with just a few roll downs. Let your shoulders roll down and back. I want you to take a peek at your feet. Make sure they're hip distance and parallel. Go ahead and pick up all 10 toes and fan them out. Really place them down nice and methodically. Get your tail underneath you. Here we are, big inhale. On that exhale, chin to chest, just round and roll yourself down. Let your knees be soft. Maybe pedal out the legs for the first one. Head, neck, and shoulders, just hang heavy for a second. And then finding center, big inhale. And then exhale, get the tailbone underneath you. Start to round and roll yourself up. Let's add a little bit of arm work here. Reach the arms up, take a nice stretch back. And then on that exhale, biceps, just frame the ears, round and roll yourself down. Big inhale, and then keep those arms nice and long. Roll yourself on up. Arms come down, maybe get a little knee bend. We do that two more times. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, exhale, roll it on up. Two more, reach. Exhale, down we go. Inhale, exhale, roll it up. One more, reach. And then go down, 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 down. Big inhale, exhale, roll it on up. And then here we are, I'm gonna face you guys. Let your arms just be nice and long. Roll those shoulders down. Let's go for just a nice jumping jack. Nothing crazy. We're breathing, and again, I've got my ankle weights on my wrists right now, just to give my shoulders and my arms just a little extra. You don't need to. If you don't have weights, you could hold those cans or just something in your hand to give you a little extra resistance. And if you want to, maybe mix it up. Take those arms straight out and squeeze them in. Feel like your lats are sliding down your back. Good, but we're breathing. Neck is nice and long. Let's be here just for 15 more seconds. Good. Last five. Good, we breathe. Last four. Warming up through the toes. Last three. Two. And then last one. Here we are. I'm going to face the opposite direction. Form over form. Push into those forms. One arm presses up, one arm presses down. Get the shoulder heads down the spine. Float a leg up. Set it down. Float a leg up. Set it down. So just alternating here. Really think of sucking your stomach in. Your shoulders. Again, don't let them hike up. And then the standing foot, really grip the earth with it. So as you step a leg or float a leg up, pull your stomach away from it. Maybe you reach those elbows a little further forward. Good. Couple more like this. Picking up the pace just a little bit. Try to keep length in your back. You're not rounding. Good, we're here just for 10 more seconds. Good, let's go for five. Think of when you do a mountain climber. It's just like a standing mountain climber. Last four. Good for three. Last two. Last one. Take your shoulders, roll them down. Okay, just warming up one more time, standing up. Feet are parallel hip distance. Reach your arms forward. Pause for me here. Just finding a nice little squat position, nothing crazy. You're not rounding at your back, if anything, slight little tuck. Arms reach away in opposition. Squeeze, come to stand. So warming up through the feet and the ankles still. I want you to feel like your arches, the center of the foot, it's like a little suction cup. You're lifting up and really pressing evenly from side to side. Let's go for five. Start to walk the feet together here. Let's go for four. So you've got one leg now. Three, two, one more. We just hold it down. Stay low for me. Flip the palms inwards. Again, retract the shoulders. Knees together, inner thighs connected, stomach in. Keep that right arm where it is. Take that left elbow. Pull it back. Now look at it. Double check your knees are still squeezed together. Get a little lower. Come through center, switch. Going to the right and center. So just finding some rotation through the rib cage, through the mid back, not through the hips and the pelvis. Good, breathing here. Finding center, go back to standing up and down. So really zipping the inner thighs together, finding the pelvic floor to pull inwards and upwards. Last six. Your navel is climbing upwards. For four. Good. Gazes forward every time. Three. Two. One more. We're going to hold it down low and pause. Now again, flip those palms inwards. Get the hips down level and low. Right arm stays quiet. Take your left arm. Just open it. Really reach like somebody's pulling in opposition. Get a little lower. Find center. Right arm. Reach it. Lower and center. Keep going. Breathing here. Finding all those stabilizer muscles to get a little love. One more. Center to the right. Center, hold it, maybe get a little lower. Pause for me here, go down an inch, up an inch, down an inch, up an inch. Hands can always come to the hips. Stomach pulls away from the thighs. Zip the inner thighs together, get a little lower. Hold it, find stabilization. Inner thighs are connected, big toes are down, pinky toes are down. Last set of pulses, here we go. No bouncing, we breathe, let's go eight. Head is in line with the spine. Stomach is in. My heart rate is up. We just started. Three, two, hold it, and come to stand. Squeeze. Walk towards the top of your mat. We take a seat now. Okay, so once we're here, cross one leg around so that your inner thighs are fully connected. And here we go. Once we're there, same deal again. Forearm over forearm. Press into those forearms. Keep the crown of the head reaching up towards the ceiling. Slowly lower down. Slowly lower down. And once we're down, we're down. Okay. So once you're there, towel is going to come in handy in just a second. So place it off to the side. Inner thighs, connect them. Hands behind those hamstrings. Really use your biceps, use your back muscles here. Sit up nice and tall. Big inhale and then exhale. Roll back. Let's just do a half roll back here. First couple ones, just warm up the spine. Staying here, and if you need to keep the hands there, they stay there. Otherwise, you reach them forward. Reach through the fingertips, but plug the shoulder heads down. Feet are still heavy into the mat. Inhale here, and then exhale. Reach forward as you extend your spine. Sit up nice and tall. To make this nicer, slide the feet away from you, just to give your hip flexors a little bit of space. Now take it down a little more. Shoulder heads nice and heavy, gazes forward, and then roll it up. So every time, we're eventually gonna make our way down to our mat. I want you to roll down maybe an inch further every single time. Just an inch. Test the waters. Keep the chest peeled open. Keep the feet nice and heavy. Find that scoop of your waistline. Roll it on up. If it feels good, reach those arms up. If that feels good or that helps you get length in your back, do it. And then arms come forward. Let's just do two more. Reach the fingertips. Roll down a little further. Right back behind the pelvis. It gets a little scarier, but that's okay. We're gonna breathe, exhale, roll it on up. Last one. Last one. Roll down. Take your time. Take your time. You're down. You're down. You're down. You're down. And you're down. Grab your towel. So what I want us to do with our towel, hold on to it so that when you pull it tautly, your knuckles are in line with your shoulders, okay? And then keep your feet where they are. They're just gonna stay bent, or legs will stay bent, excuse me. Reaching up, now pretend like you're holding on to a true dowel. You wanna pull that dowel apart, pull the shoulder heads heavy into the spine, suck your tummy in, here we go, big inhale. Exhale, lift forward, then up we go. Here we are, first one. That towel is just resting right on top of your thighs. Double check you haven't tilted your tailbone or tucked your pubic bone. Your tail is heavy, you have very light pressure into your feet. Lift and curl a little higher, and then take that shape right back down. Keeping that dowel consistent in line with your shoulders, lift up, then over. Keeping the gaze forward, pull that dowel apart, feel those lats fire up. And then take it down. I'm calling it a dowel, but it's a towel, but you know, whatever. Two more. Lift up, curl forward. Gazes forward, lift up one more inch. Last time here. Take it down. Enjoy it. If it feels good, maybe take those arms back behind if that feels nice. Now reach those arms up, lift the chest, curl forward and pause. Now once you're there. Keep that upper back exactly where it is. Just the arms. Reach them back. and forward. Just go to where you feel stabilization in your shoulders. You shouldn't feel any pain, but you're actively pulling that towel apart. You're actively keeping your torso and your pelvis quiet. And as those arms go back, see if you can lift your chest maybe another inch. Let's just go for five. You're building some heat in those abs right now, finding those stabilizer muscles to fire up. Let's go three. Keep that chest lifted. Go two. One more. Hold it here, lift up a little higher, reach the arms up, and then carefully tap it down. Pause for me here. Float the legs into that tabletop. Keep your imaginary dowel right up over your shoulders. Both legs reach them out. Both legs pull them in. If you need to modify, go to that single-legged variation. Do that. You're breathing though. Let's go for four. We add on here in just a second, but keep pulling that towel apart. Keep the shoulder heads heavy. Three. Keep the shoulders anchored in two. Okay, next time, keep those legs out there. Now as you pull the knees in, find a little tuck of the hips and then reach the legs out. So keep your shoulders down. Keep that dowel right up over your face or over your chest. And then as you pull those knees in, really contract your low belly muscles to do the work here. The more you can keep the heels towards the seat and stay nice and compact, the more work you'll put into your stomach. Let's go just for four. This is our break. Let's go just for three. We lift the head, neck, and shoulders next in two. One more. One more. Pull it in. Take the feet right back down. Now pause for me there. Shoulder heads heavy. Inhale, exhale, lift and curl. Hold it here. Try to slide that towel up a little higher. Stay with me. Chest stays open. Right leg, reach it long and bend it. Left leg, reach it long and bend it. You can always rest the head. You can always keep the feet flat. Next time a leg goes out, hold it there. Opposite leg goes out, lift, start pumping for your hundreds. Again, you can always lower those legs right back down, but you're reaching that towel up towards the top of your toes. Your chest is lifted. This towel is making you move your arms together as one unit. Squeeze those inner thighs, try to relax your quads. Try to really work the squeeze of the heels. As if I were coming by and trying to pinch your heels. You wouldn't be able to let my fingers get through the squeeze. Now hold it, pause for me there. Bend the knees in, curl, curl, curl. Take that towel, it goes under the legs. Lift higher and pump. Try not to let the towel graze the back of your hamstring. Keep lifting and keep reaching. In through the nose for five, out through the mouth for five. Hold, bend those knees in, curl, curl, curl. Legs go out, pump over the thighs. Stay lifted. Breathing here. Keep climbing up. Chin out of the chest, hold. Last time, bend those knees in. Last set here, lift. Try to keep the collarbones broad and breathe. We've got three. Yes, we've got two. Hold it, bend those knees in. Slide the legs long along the mat. Hold it here. Arms are long, roll up. First one's always a little shaky. Now reach forward and then roll yourself down. And take those arms back behind if it feels good. Lift them up, curl up. Now reach forward and up as you roll up. And breathe. Go a little faster today. Just a little faster, nothing crazy. Good, but breathing still. If you wanna make this more challenging, you keep the biceps by the ears the entire time. That keeps that lever just a little longer. But keep the shoulder heads heavy if we do this. Keep them heavy. We've got three more. Taking whatever variation you want, I want you to still pull that towel apart. Keep the shoulders sliding down the spine. One more and we hold it. One more and we hold it. Rolling up. And then pause for me here. Reach forward, roll halfway back and pause. Adjust your towel if you feel like you've pulled it apart. Walk your hands a little more narrow. Now find that spot again where it feels like your feet want to float up. Keep reaching through the knuckles, keep the chest lifted, try to lengthen at your low back. Now reach those arms a little higher. Squeeze your seat, right leg lifts to tap the towel. Now as you lower the leg, reach it as you lower it. Don't move your spine. Yes. Left leg lifts and lower. So if your arms are too high, check your shoulders. Lower the arms a little bit if you need to. Good, but breathe. Let's go three. Good, we breathe. Let's go two. One more, hold whatever leg is up there, I don't care. Take that opposite leg up there. Now just hold. Good, first teaser. Maybe lift those arms a little more. Stomach is in, let's go three. Good, breathe, let's go two. Hold it, keep reaching, keep lifting. Take your legs down, don't move that towel, squeeze and reach. Take those legs up. Yes, two more. Legs go down with control, control it. Ooh. And lift it, suck your belly in. One more. Yes, we can, yes, we can. Down. Legs go down, stay lifted. Hold it here, roll it down. Arms go back, roll it up. Just two more. We've got a little variation next. One more. Hold it here, sit up tall, reach the arms up. Now zip your inner thighs together like you have one leg. Flex your ankles, so push your heels away. Now reach those arms up. You can always take them slightly forward. Shoulder heads nice and heavy. Extend at your lumbar spine. On that inhale, twist to the left. Twist. Now you haven't leaned back. Sit up taller. And then exhale, center. Over to the right. Big twist. And center. Now hold it here. On the next one, hold that twist. Now pause for me there. Look at your feet, big toes are still connected. Extend your spine on that diagonal, don't go far. Squeeze your butt, hinge back. Don't go far, keep those feet heavy. Exhale, lift. Do it again. Squeeze the inner thighs together. As you hinge back, push your heels forward. Go two more. It's like you're on your short box. And lift, now hold it here, find center. Over to the right, find the twist first, then hinge, and tall. Find the reach and tall. Who cares how far you go? Go three more. Keep the biceps by the ears. One more. And center. Hold it. Reach those arms forward. Roll back. Ditch your towel. Roll down. Once you're there, you're there. Okay, give yourself a little bit of space. So arms are nice and long by your side. Feet are parallel hip distance. Shoulder heads are nice and heavy. Okay, here we go. Preparing for a bridge. We're just going to do three of them. Big inhale. And then on that exhale, scoop your navel, roll yourself on up. So this is where if you guys have hand weights, grab them. If you have some hand weights and you want to use them, have them off to the side. First one here, press those arms heavy. Get the inner thighs to feel like they're hugging the midline. Knees should feel like they're reaching forward. Big inhale and then exhale. Keep the hips up there. As you roll through the spine first. Do that two more times. Big inhale, exhale, roll it on up. Good, breathing in, exhale, roll it down. Give our hips a little love after what we just did. Last one, we're gonna hold it up and pause. Hold it up, now keep the hips where they are. Reach the arms up towards the ceiling, flip the palms inwards. Now, if you don't have hand weights, just move with control and think about the muscles that we're working. Soft bend in your elbows. I want you to open your arms like you're about to hug. Your hips haven't moved. Exhale, squeeze. So if you do have hand weights, you want that soft bend in your elbows. Keep the shoulder heads down. And maybe hold those arms out there for that half second. Just feel that catch in the top of your shoulder. Right where your armpit attaches to your chest. And you're breathing. Let's go just for four like this. Good, we're breathing. We'll add a little hinge of the hips in three. Little hinge of the hips in two. Hold it. Now as I open my arms, tap the hips down. As I lift the hips, arms come up. Open and tap. Lift and extend. If this doesn't feel good in your body, just keep your arms down by your side and go with the hinge. Let's go four. Good, keep scooping the waistline up towards your chest. Go three. Good, breathe, go two. Hold the lift, now pause here. If your feet kind of escaped you, walk them in a little bit closer towards your hip bones. Keep the arms up, but keep the shoulders heavy. Now hips stay level. I want you to float that right leg into a tabletop. First one, just pause. Extend that left hip a little more without shifting in your side body. That foot finds the floor. And you alternate. So as we're doing this, we're thinking of those chopsticks that are flanking our body right now. And we're keeping even length through our side body muscles as a foot just floats up and it floats right back down. And of course, if you need to, just take your arms down by your side. It'll offer a little more extension, but I want you to really push the earth away with that standing foot. Go four. Good, we breathe, go three. Inner thighs are stretching towards the midline. Two. One more, both feet find the floor. Now pause for me here, press those arms down. Stomach is in, now without your ribs going anywhere, take your arms back, tap the hips down. Stomach in, lift the hips up, press the arms down. So everything taps and lifts. We got five. Nothing crazy, keep your stomach in. Keep those even pressure points through the foot. Go three. Good, breathe, go two. Last one, hold the arms down. Now stay with me, your arms are down, your hips are high. Right leg is gonna lift and pause. Right leg extends, now hold it here, push through that left hip. I want you to take your right leg, open it out to the right only as much as your pelvis doesn't shift and your left inner thigh doesn't buckle. Exhale, center. So you're tracing a line with your toes over to the right and then right back through center. Nothing spinally is moving. You're getting a little abduction of the hip. You're taking it away. Go four. Good, you're strengthening that standing leg. Go three. Press through those arms, go two. Hold it here. Now lift up a little more. Take that leg down. Flex the ankle lift. Point the toe, reach. Flex the ankle lift. Your full shoulder bridge. You're nice and stable through that standing leg. We've got five. Good, breathe. I'm not in a pulsing mood, so yay. Let's go three. Good, breathe, go two. Hold it, get a little higher, bend the knee, foot finds the floor. Arms are down by your side, readjust as needed, hips are level. Stay here with me, left leg comes up, extend it. Hold it here, push through that right heel. Little open to the left and center. So maybe with this leg, you can't go as far and that's okay. Pelvis is level, right inner thigh. She has not moved. That right knee is anchored in space. Go three. Your stomach is in, your triceps are on. Go two. Center pause. Hold it here, lift higher, take the leg down, flex the ankle, lift. Pointed toe lengthens, flexed ankle lifts. Right inner thigh is on. We are breathing. We've got four. Series of five is coming next. Let's go three. Let's go two. One more. Hold it, lift higher. Bend the knee, foot finds the floor. Stay here, take your feet a little wider for me now. In this open V position, heels in, toes out. I want you to find little pulses. Just to really make sure we've got the seat nice and fired up. Big toes and pinky toes, evenly weighted. Okay, our arches are lifted. You're working those external hip rotators. Now make your range of motion bigger and bigger until your butt taps and lifts. Tap and lift. Let's go eight. Just making sure we've got the seat fired up for later. Let's go five. Good, squeeze evenly. Four, press through those arms. Two, one, hold at the top. Get it, get it, get it, get it. And then take it down. Hold the down, pull the knees into the chest, maybe rock from side to side. And then we are gonna go for our rolling like a ball into our series of five. So finding center, hands are on your shins. Chin to chest, just go for a little momentum to start, that's okay. And then maybe at the top and pause. So once you're up there, your feet are off of the floor. Depending on the flexibility, you reach for the ankles, the shins, back behind the hamstrings, whatever you need to do. You do you, boo. Okay, so heels together. Now find that nice C curl of your spine. Keep the shoulders heavy. Here we go. Go just to the shoulders and back up balance. Stomach pulls in to get that lumbar spine to round. And you're trying to roll evenly on the back. So this teaches you a lot about your spine. It gives you feedback. Use less momentum. Try not to kick the feet away. Try to keep the head a little closer in between the thigh bones, maybe. We've got five more to practice, though. Good. Maybe try to get those knees to be like earmuffs. Go for two. Okay, one more. One more. Hold it at the top and pause. I'm going to scooch back a little bit. Hold it at the top. Now stay with me. Go slow. I want you to take your left leg slightly out. Left hand reaches for the right knee. Right hand reaches for the right ankle. With control, take your time. Get down. Now pause here. Really pull that knee in so outside hand reaches for the ankle. Single leg stretch. Inhale, exhale, switch. Outside hand reaches for the ankle. And breathe. So you're imagining you're tapping your toe in the same spot every single time. Your shoulder heads are heavy. Let's go five. Where your upper back is where it stays. If you ever need to rest the head, you rest the head. Three. Good breathing. Two. Both knees in. Now pause. Reach for those ankles. Curl up a little higher. We're doing three variations. Stay here. First variation, arms and legs reach out and pause. Your chest is still lifted. Inner thighs are still connected. Now as you pull those knees in, reach for the ankles. Curl deeper. Now try to stay there. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Three more. Inhale, reach. Exhale, pull. Scoop that belly in. Hold. Now keep those legs in the same spot. Take the arms back this time. Hold it here. Just the arms open to a T. Pause. Lift the chest. Just the arms reach forward. Pull everything in. Everything reaches. One. Just the arms open. Two. Arms forward. Three. Exhale, pull. Four. Three more. Arms open. Forward. Knees. Reach. Arms open, arms forward, knees. Two more. Reach, open, forward, pull. Last one. Last one. Open, reach, forward. Now pull. Now hold it here. Last one. Everything reaches. Now pause. Chest is lifted. Stomach is in. Find that length. Take the legs up. Lift your chest. Hold on to that right leg. Send the left leg down. Keep the shoulder heads heavy. Pull, pull. And switch. Pull, pull, and switch. Good. No momentum. You're breathing. You're stretching those hamstrings after that bridge series. So really push the toes up towards the ceiling. Keep the chin out of the chest. Last four. Good. Breathe. Go three. I'm going to mix up the order today. Who cares? Let's go two. Last one. Pull the knees in. We're going for our crisscross. Thank me later. Hands back behind the head. Elbows wide. Take the legs out, hold it here. Pull the knees in, twist to the left. Stay lifted, take the legs out, find center. Pull the knees in, twist to the right. Legs out center, knees in, twist left. Legs out center, knees in, twist left. One more, reach. Now hold it here, pull that left knee in, twist. Inhale, exhale, switch. Stay lifted, inhale, exhale, switch. And switch. And switch. We go eight. Good breathing. Six. Staying lifted. Four. Good. Stay lifted. Two. One more. Hold it here. Center. Take those hands behind the hamstrings. Okay, grand finale. Here we are. Shoulder heads heavy. Stay lifted. This was our little break. Hands come back. Take those legs up towards the ceiling. Lift the chest. Take the legs halfway down. Lift them up. Halfway down, lift them up, keep that chest lifted. Two more. Good, one more. Now hold the legs down, stay with me. Right leg taps the floor and lifts. Left leg taps the floor and lifts. Stay lifted, go four. Good, breathe. Three. Legs come down in two. Hold it, take the legs down, pause. Elbows are wide, squeeze your seat, just lift and lift and lift. Yes, we can, we're breathing. Four, three, two, hold. Reach the arms forward, roll up. Hold that stretch, give yourself that stretch. Pull the knees in. Whew. We got one more thing and then we're out of this. Okay, hold it here. We did our rolling like a ball. You can always go back to that. But why? Let's try something different. Hold on to those feet. Last little ab series, then we come onto all fours. Hold it for me here. Right leg, reach it and bend it. Left leg, reach it and bend it. So, open leg rocker, yes please. Hold on to both legs. Here we are. I think of my legs as uprights, football uprights. Lift your chest through those uprights. Really extend from your lumbar spine. Holding on, shoulders heavy. From that stomach, pull it in first. Roll to the shoulders, right back up. Find your balance, do it again. Rounding and lifting. So really extend your back every time. Hands can always be behind the hamstrings, that's okay. One more. And center. Now hold it here. Zip the inner thighs together. You have one leg. Same deal. Your legs are just together. Roll back. And up. Ooh, two more. Roll back. And up. Yes, we can. One more. One more. Roll back. And up. Now pause. This is the grand finale. I told you we got one more thing, but I didn't, but I'm telling you now. Reach those arms forward. Hold that shape. Keep that shape consistent. Roll that shape back. And up. Ooh, two more. Roll that shape back. And up. Test your balance. You can do it. Yes, you can. One more. One more. And up. Hold it. Lift that chest. And bend it in. Give yourself a little stretch. So go for this butterfly stretch. Let the soles of your feet come together. And our transition, we're just going to come onto all fours. So coming onto all fours, you're done with your towel, so you can ditch your towel. Okay, once you guys are there, hi sweetie, go sit down please. Okay, once you guys are there, take your hands, just let them be shoulder distance, knees are right underneath your hips. Go for a nice cat to cow here, just stretch out what we worked. I'm so sweaty, my boobs are so sweaty, you guys. You're doing great. Okay, come through center, go over here please. Coming through center, now let's start with the left leg. Reach your left leg nice and long. If you need to, you can always come down onto those forearms or you can come to fists, whatever works for you. Right knee directly underneath your hip. Roll that left hip back down, lift your chest. Now start just with that leg. Reach that leg back behind you, make it long, and then just begin to tap and lift. Just notice where you're moving the leg from. You're moving from your seat, not from the knee joint. Your stomach is in. Think eyes down, chest up. Now if this feels okay, great. Take your right arm, reach it forward. I like my palm to face inwards, my thumb to face up. Notice that nothing has changed in your left shoulder. Now keep going. We're just gonna add the arm and the leg. Arm and leg do the same thing. As the arm comes down, the leg comes down. As the arm goes up, the leg comes up. Your trunk is stable, meaning your stomach and your midsection. Go four. Good, we breathe. Go three, try to relax your foot. Really work from the seat. Go two. Hold that length. Now pause for me there. Elbow to knee, exhale, curl. Inhale, extend. Exhale, curl. Inhale, extend. Let's just go five. Good breathing. You can always take the hand down. Just go for the knee tuck. Two, last one, hold it. Now keep the arm and the leg long, just the leg, draw circles. Drawing circles, elbow is soft on that left arm. Two, one, reverse the circle. Reverse, reach, and reach. Oh, my foot is shaking. Three, two, one, hold it. I'm gonna take my hand down. Now hold your hands down. Chest is lifted, keep that leg reaching away. I'm gonna take my elbows wide today. My chest goes down as my leg comes up, and then I press, lift, and and lower. So the leg just stays connected to the body. You're keeping your hips square, keeping your pelvis stable. Go four. Oh my God, my foot is shaking. Go three. Good, go two. Last one, hold it here. Now take that leg forward and pause. Your leg is now forward, it's gonna stay forward. I want you to take a scooch back with your right leg, frame your foot with your hands, and just kind of lean into that right hip. Give yourself a nice stretch and breathe. So I want you to think of your knee stretches on the reformer. That's what we're gonna do, or thereabouts. So now tuck your right toes under, or think of when you're on the box, or excuse me, when we're on the chair. So think of step ups on the chair. That's what we're kind of gonna work into now. Extend that right knee, now pause for me here. I want your fingertips to be lightly touching. Your knee is directly over your ankle. This angle is not gonna change. Lift your ribs up towards the ceiling, round your back away from your thigh. Stay low, bend that right leg in and out. You're just going in and out and breathing. So the weight is in the heel. You're not moving in your spine. Think of when you're pumping your foot on the chair, when you're standing on top of it and the back foot is on the pedal, it's the same motion right now. We've got three, we've got two. Step your right foot forward to be right next to your left. Come to stand and pause. Take your right heel, lift it up for me. Hands can come to a prayer position. You lower down, think of a single leg squat and lift. You go down and up. We're doing this series two more times. Building some heat into that left cheek right now. And breathing. So now it's more like a hinge of your hips. As you go down, you're pushing your hips back, but your right heel is lifted. Three. Trying to put a little more weight into that left seat. Two. Hold it low. Pause. Hands come down. Back into those presses. Maybe your foot on that right leg never touches the floor. Keep the hips stable. Stomach is in. Five. Four. Three. Two. Hold it. Step the foot up. Second set. Your butt cheek should be on fire right now. And breathe. Let your gaze be forward. Stand up tall every time. Four. We got one more set to do. Three. Two. Down. Hands down. Leg goes out and in. Try to really round. And round. Maybe if you want to, curl into a tight ball and then reach a little bit. Curl and reach. Four. Three. Two. Hold it. Find center. Here we are, last set. Oh, last set, we're breathing. Good big press. Let's go eight. We roll it down, do a little back extension, and move along in four, three, two. Oh, get low, just get there. Just be there, little pulses. Yes, we can, we're breathing. Strong butts are being built in this quarantine. Four. Three, two, hold it, lower the heel, reach the arms up, squeeze, roll it down. Oh, pedal out the legs. Once we pedal out those legs, make sure you got some space. Hands come forward onto your mat, legs go back with control. Come down to those knees. We're gonna go into a little bit of back extension. Here we are. Okay, hands, they're gonna come slightly forward of your mat. So I want you to think of taking your hands maybe more towards the corners of the mat. The further away, the nicer this will be. The closer in, the more this will be. So pick whatever feels good for you. Going for some basic back extension. Zip your inner thighs together for me. Pelvis is heavy into the mat. Stomach is in. Now keep your chest up, put your eyes down. Light
pressure through the hands, if any pressure at all. On the inhale, lift just the upper back. Use your upper back extensors to float your chest up off of the mat. Ask yourself if you could pick your hands up. And then see if you can lift up a little higher. Stomach is in. Now as you lower down, reach through the crown of the head. Reach, reach, reach. So my elbows are bent to start, so I have something to push away from. Here we go, lifting up. Shins are heavy, toenails are heavy. Now if it feels okay, start to push through the heel of the hand. Lifting up, your gaze is forward. Stomach is in, your chest is trying to burst through your forearms. Keep the shins heavy. Begin to bend those elbows, lower yourself down. We're going for our neck roll. So next one, lift yourself up. Use those upper back extensors first. Then push through the heel of the hand and lift. Stomach is in, look to the left for me. Chin to chest, down, over to the right, look forward. Look to the right, chin to chest, over to the left, and center. Two more, stay lifted, left, over and down to the right, center, right, over and down, center, take the shape down. Pause for me here. Go ahead and take your legs, separate them so they're maybe like an X. So if your hands were out and your arms were out, your body would be an X position. And then take forearm over forearm. Just let your forehead rest into your forearms. And then from here, all I want you to do, find length in your legs. Squeeze your butt, and when you do that, notice what happened. Your thigh bones left the mat a little bit. I want you to work, find that length in the legs. Keep your thigh bones slightly lifted. Bend your knees, connect your heels. So your knees are wide, but your heels are together. Lengthen your legs and reach. So now combine the two. Flex your ankles, heels connect. Point your toes, legs reach away. Keep going. As we're doing this though, our shoulder heads are staying down. Our thigh bones are floating off of our mat because we're really lengthening and squeezing our muscles to the bone. You're squeezing your thigh bone muscles onto your thigh. Squeezing your butt cheeks onto your thigh bone. Or your butt bone, whatever that is. Four. Good, breathe. Two. One more. Heels connected. Hold the heels connected. Flex the seat. Stomach is in, just lift. And lift. And lift. And lift. Four. Three. Two. Hold the lift. Pause for me there. Just pulse up and up and up and up. Five, three, two, and down we go. Ooh. Okay, we got one more thing. So pretend like you're on your reformer right now. You're on your long box. Make sure you've got space off to the side. Again, zip those inner thighs together as best to your ability. Take your arms out to a T. Let your palms face down. Hold the lift of your chest so your neck is long, your stomach is in. Float your arms up so they're just in line with your body. Now hold those palms facing down. Keep the shins, keep the toenails heavy. On that inhale, take your pinkies and try to tap your hips and pause. Your palms are still down, your collarbones are broad. Now as you take your arms back to that T, take the chest down. Do it again. Lift up, pinkies to hips, gaze is forward and down. And then exhale, take the chest down. Just tap your nose to the mat. Lifting up on an inhale or an exhale, whatever breath works for you. And then down you go. Three more. Try to keep the shoulder heads in the same spot, so palms face down. Two more. One more. Hold the lift. Now pause for me here. Palms face the floor. Take that little side bend. So your hip bones stay nice and heavy. Right fingertips slide towards the right toes. Left fingertips slide towards the left toes. Keep those hips evenly weighted. Four. It's getting a little bit of side bending in. Let's go three. Keep climbing the tummy up. Two. One more. Hold it center. Take the hands down. Push up. Give yourself a stretch. Okay, I just gotta remember the whole series on the other side, but we're gonna do it. Okay, taking your hands right underneath your shoulders, Knees right underneath the hips, right leg this time. We're gonna send that right leg out. Give yourself a second. Square yourself off. I like to keep my toes heavy to start just to kind of get myself in my setup. You can always come to fists or come to hands. Start just with the leg lifted up and lower it down. So find your gaze slightly forward of your mat. So your neck is long, you have a soft bend in your elbows. If we're okay here, this is when we extended that left arm. And again, double check, when you took the arm away, did your right shoulder buckle? Try to relax your right foot, just really work from your seat. Lift and lift. And we're breathing. Let's go four, use that stomach, really suck your navel in right now. Let's go three, let's go two. Hold the leg up and pause. Now it's knee to elbow. On that exhale, round, think tailbone under, and then inhale, reach. Exhale, tailbone wraps under, inhale, lengthen. Find that layout, really reach, 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 reach. Let's go three. Don't sell yourself short, find that full range of motion. Two, good, one more, hold it, get your chest up, circle the leg. Circle the leg without moving the pelvis. Pelvis is absolutely stable. Your chest is up. If you need to take the hand down, take the hand down. Soft bend, whoo, three. Sometimes the basics gang, they just do it. Let's go two, hold it, reverse the circle, reach. And reach, try to keep the top of the foot parallel to the floor. So really circle through the hip socket, not through the ankle. Three. Good, let's go two. Hold it, make your leg longer. Now walk those hands a little wider if you need to. Your option, either nice chest push-up, or you can go for that tricep push-up where your elbows just raise your rib cage. Push evenly through the hands, make the leg longer. Four. We breathe, three, we're almost done, two, hold the lift, now pause for me here, step that foot forward, give yourself a second, kind of stretch your left leg out, maybe some of you are flexible enough to do your splits, this would be a good opportunity to do that right now, otherwise, for the rest of us who aren't there yet, take your foot, let it come down, hands frame your foot, back leg, those toes tuck under and you extend that knee. Hold it for me here. You may need to adjust your back foot. That's okay. Come to your fingertips. Double check your knee is directly over your ankle and that's where it's going to stay. Round your upper back. So let your gaze be down. Pull your stomach away from your thigh. Begin to pump the back leg in without shifting in the hips. So you stay stable. You pump that back leg in and out. Good, and you're breathing. Try to keep your neck long. So look down at your foot. You're not shifting in your knee. You're nice and stable. Four. Good. Three. Working those stabilizers. Two. Step your foot forward. Pause. Your heel is lifted. Come to stand.
Oh, I'm so wobbly. Come to stand. Hands come in front of you. Go down and up. Oh, oh my goodness. Down. And my ankle weights are like translating down to my butt right now. I don't know how that happened, but it's like this is more challenging on my butt. Whatever, personal problems. Just talking to myself in my living room. You guys are doing great. Four. Left heel is lifted. Three. Two. Hold it. Two more sets. Here we go. Round it down. Light touch through the fingertips. Try to get that thigh bone parallel to the floor. You go out and in, and if we did so before, stay low. Maybe don't let that left foot find the floor though. You're not shifting back and forth. You're reaching. Spine is stable. It's always about the spine. Go four, go three, two, last one. Take the foot back in. Second set of pulses, or not even pulsing. We're just going down and up. I told you I wasn't in a pulsing mood. So we're not gonna be in a pulsing mood for our right leg. Down and up. Good, five. And if you like a pistol squat, shit, don't let me stop you from doing them. Take that foot off the floor if you can. Go three, go two, hold it, last set, down, round your spine. Take the leg out
end in. Try to get a little lower. If you did so on that other side, kind of bend a little deeper, then extend. Bend a little deeper and extend. Oh, your butt's gonna feel it. Let's go five. Good, breathing still. Four, three, two, last one. Take the foot in. Last set. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
So just so you know, I'll keep your brain occupied right now. We're gonna go into some side bending after this and then we're out of here. Last five. We'll get a little arm work in, a little side bending in. Three. Well, we gotta finish with this last set. Hold it down. This was the only thing I pulsed. This was it. Get a little lower. Just hold that stable squat. Last set of pulses. Up an inch, down an inch. Ooh, I am breathing heavy. Four. You're doing great, gang. Three, two, oh, stand it up, reach. And then take a forward fold. Pedal out the legs. I wish I had a nice transition for you here, but I don't. So we're just gonna come down to our knees and we're gonna finish in this side kneeling position. Okay. Let me catch my breath. Okay, once we're here, feet are parallel, or I should say hips are parallel. Take your arms out to a T. All we're doing here is finding length. Can you please? Thank you. Okay, so get your tailbone directly underneath you. Stomach is in. If you have hand weights, this is where you would hold them. We go for just a nice little bicep curl here. Nothing is moving in the body. Righter, not right now. Thank you. Can you take this over there? There you go. So nothing is moving. Those arms are just reaching away from the body and bending in. So you're not on your reformer, but imagine, or maybe you are, but imagine you have the strap in your hand. Every time we do bicep curls on the reformer, that tension fully lengthens our arm. So do that same thing right now, just with your own muscle. Fully reach and bend. Go four. We're gonna go for a little side bend in three. Good, in two. Hold it. Flip the arms down, hold the arms down. Now we're gonna go to the left. Again, tailbone under. Take it down to the left. Now hold it here. Extend that right leg out. Lift up through your right fingertips, hands back behind the head. Flex that ankle. Kick the leg forward. Point the toes, sweep. Flex, kick, point, sweep. Your stomach is in. Now try to just let your head be in line with your spine. Good, five. You guys are almost there. Stay strong. Last three. Good, breathe. Last two. One more, hold it, reach the arm up, bend the knee, big inhale, exhale, right back through center. Pause for me here, reach the arms forward, flip the palms, so I'll face this direction so you can see. Tailbone heavy, bicep curl, nothing crazy. Shoulder head slide down the spine. I gotta keep going, I gotta finish because Instagram will kick me off if this is over an hour. Go four, breathe, go three. Breathe, go two. Last one, hold those arms long. Open out to that T, I'll face this direction again. Okay, now this time, arms are open. Take that tilt over to the right. To the right, to the right. Hold the leg long, get the tail underneath you first. Hand back behind the head, flex the ankle, kick the leg, point the toe, sweep. Flex, kick, point, sweep. So really supported through that right side, lifting. Keeping the tailbone heavy. Four. Chin out of the chest. Three. Two. One more. One more. Hold the leg long. Bend the knee. Reach the arm up. Lift up. Squeeze everything together. Arms back in front of you. I'll face this way now. Once your arms are there, flip those palms. Elbows, they are bent. They're going to stay bent. Stomach stays in. I want you to open and close. Keep the ribs in your body. This is where we finish, gang. You're super almost done. Working your rhomboid, so those mid-back muscles, head stays on top of the body. I want you to slide your shoulder heads down towards your hip bones. Go four. This is where we finish. We've got our thighs stretched to finish us off. Two, one more. Hold it center. Just lift and lift. Without letting your scapula elevate. Five. Good, squeeze your seat, get your tailbone heavy, abdominals pull upwards. Two, hold the elbows in line with the shoulders, reach the arms forward, flip the palms down, keep those shins heavy, get the tail underneath you.
On that inhale, hinge from your knees, hinge. But like you're trying to touch somebody in front of you, you're reaching, 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 and lift. Now reach the arms up, up, up. Feel length in your side body. Arms come forward, hinge, hinge, hinge. Maybe go a little further and lift. Use those inner thighs. Feel like you're squeezing through a yoga block right now. Two more. Keep the big toes heavy. Keep the shins heavy. One more. Stomach and last one. Here we go. Last one. Last one. Reach, reach, reach. Now as you come forward, take your hands down. Tuck your toes under. This is where we finish. Heels together, toes apart. Squeeze your seat, glide forward and back. This is it, gang. This is where we finish. You can do this. Chest is lifted. All 10 toes serve a purpose right now. Squeeze your inner thighs. Wrap your glutes. Good, breathe. Last 8. Stomach is in. Chest is lifted. 4. 3 more. Wrap. Go 2. Hold it here. Chin to chest. Walk yourself back. 3. 2. Hang heavy. Roll yourself all the way back up. Roll your shoulders down and back. And we did it. Oh my goodness. I still got my hair up. I'm sweaty. My wrists are sweaty. You guys did fantastic. Oh, yay, Deb. Did you do it, Deb? Yay. I miss you guys so much. I love all of you. Today's a beautiful day. So I hope you get some sunshine. Hi, Sarah. Oh my God, I love you guys. Thank you so much, Allie. Oh my gosh, I'm fangirling here over you guys. Okay, guys, I love you. I hope you had a great workout. Get some sunshine. Keep moving. You guys are doing it. You're keeping moving. This is what it's all about. Stay on a schedule. I love y'all. All right. See you guys later.